Today we are going to start with a new concept, division. Division means distributing something into equal parts or groups. It is a way of sharing equally. When I want to divide, I have to share equally. The two dots and a line help me to be fair always. Here you can see one division question is done where 638 is said dividend, 12 is a divisor, 53 is a quotient and remainder is 2. What is division algorithm? That is, dividend you will have it as quotient into divisor. You will multiply this to quotient into divisor plus remainder. So when you multiply 53 into 12 and add remainder, you should get dividend, and hence you can verify your answers. Let us see here. So here what I am getting is 636, and 636 plus 2, when you add it, that is 638, which is your dividend. So this way you can verify your answers. Let us recall the properties of division. When a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. For example, 203 divided by 1 is equal to 203. 596 divided by 1 is 596. 1230 divided by 1 is equal to 1230, and so on. It means when a number is divided by 1, you get the number itself. Let us see the other properties of division. When a number except 0 is divided by itself, then the quotient is 1. That is, 12 divided by 12 is 1, 15 divided by 15 is 1, 1536 divided by 1536 is equal to 1. That is, these two numbers are same. Then the answer is 1. That is, the quotient is 1. Now let us see the other two properties. Here the property says that when 0 is divided by any number except 0, that is, we are not talking about 0 divided by 0. We are talking about 0 divided by any number. The answer will be always 0. And the next property says that division by 0 is not possible. These two properties, how you can remember is, that is, you can remember that 0 wants always to be the first position. So if 0 is not at the first position, he will be sad. If he is in the first position, he is always happy. That is, 0 divided by 0, that is 0. 0 divided by 16 is 0. 0 divided by 10 is 0. And here, any number. Here 0 is in the second position. So he doesn't like. So he becomes very sad. That is, you have to understand as, this is not possible. Now what we have understood is, division is the process of finding out how many times a particular number, that is divisor, will fit into the given number. That is, if I say 1539 divided by 12, then it means how many times 12 will come in this number. That is, how many times a particular divisor will fit into the given number. Okay. Division is also known. You can do division by repeated subtraction method also. Okay. Third thing is that rounding off the numbers. Rounding of the numbers will help you to do the calculations faster. Now, how does one decide to which number the given number, that is divisor, should be rounded, and how to round off the numbers? Let us see here. Say you are given this question, 1539 divided by 12. That is 12 is the divisor. This number has to be rounded off. Okay, now as this is a two-digit number, this is 1's place and this is 10's place. So this number you have to round off to the nearest 10's. So how to round off the numbers to the nearest 10's? Okay, in 10, 1 digit is 0, 1 0 is there. So 1 digit, underline it, write 1 0. Now the number, the previous number you need to check, if that number is 5 or greater than 5, that is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9. If any of this number is there, then you have to add 1 to the previous number or else you will not. So here the condition is not satisfied, that is 2 is not greater than or equal to 5. So you have to write the number as it is. That is, here 1 becomes 1. So when you round off 12 to the nearest 10's, it becomes 10. Say you have 27 and you have to round off the number to the nearest 10. Then how will you do it? Nearest 10, that means 1 digit underline and write 1 0. Now check the number that you have underlined. So here it becomes 7. Is it greater than or equal to 5? No. Or yes? Yes. It is greater than 5. So you have to add 1 to the previous number. That is 2 becomes 3. Let us say one more question. Say you are given 358. And you have to round up the number to the nearest 10's. So 10, 1 digit needs to be underlined, and 10. Now check the number you have underlined. Is it greater than or equal to 5? Yes. So condition is satisfied. So 35 plus 1 becomes 36. So when this number is rounded off to the nearest 10's, this becomes 360. Fine. Now let us say that you want the number to be rounded off to the nearest 100. And let me start. Say you have the question as 7, 3, 8, 9 divided by 128. So here the divisor is 3 digit number. Okay. So here I write the number and this is 128. This is 1's place, 10's place and 100's place. So you are going to round off the number to the nearest 100. Remember that you have to round off the number to their highest place. So here the highest place is 100. So round off the number to the nearest 100's. So in 100, 2 zeros are there. So 2 digits to be underlined and 2 zeros you will write. Now the numbers which you have underlined go for the highest place. So here 2 is at the highest place. This number you need to check whether the condition is satisfied or not. That it is it greater than or equal to 5 or not? Here it is not. So the previous number is 1. So here it becomes 1. Say you are given say 259. So rounded off the number to the nearest 100. 2 digits you need to underline. 2 zeros you will write. And now the second thing, you will check the number at the higher place, the digits which you have underlined. So 5 is at the higher place and the condition is satisfied. So 2 becomes 2 plus 1, that is 3. Here let me write the greater number. Say 1, 2, 9, 5, 6. So these 2 digits I will underline and 2 zeros. Now wherever you have underlined, check the higher place digit. So here it is 5. Fine. And the condition is once again satisfied. So you have to add 1 to the previous number, that is 129 becomes 129 plus 1, that is 130. So this number, when rounded off, it becomes 13,000. But remember that we round off the numbers only to estimate the values. Whenever you are going to perform any division question, first thing what you need to do is you have to make rough column at the right side, right there RC. This is the place where you are going to do all the rough calculations. And here you are going to give space to the teacher to give the marks, to award the marks for the particular question, right? So now how you are going to start with, write the dividend, that is 12,686. You are going to divide by 51. Now first thing is that you should have the estimate within two multiplication steps only. You should guess how many times 51 will go in this number. Now how to start with? As this is two digit number, take two digits of the dividend. Here two digits of the dividend is smaller than this 51. So write two zeros, first step. Now you have to take into consideration three digits. So now the number is 126, and you need to think of how many times 51 will go in 126. Now, how to do it? You have to think of the highest place of the divisor. So here the highest place is 5. So here you have to speak the table of 5. So here you have 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15. And just go on adding 0 to that. That is, you have started, say, 5 ones are 5, so it was 50. 5 twos are 10, so it was 100. 0 you have added. 5 threes are 15 and 0 you have added. You have to think that how many times 51 will go into 126. So here 150 is a greater number. So here you can think of 2s are. Right? So here actually the number was 51. So go for 51 2s are. So here you have 102. So start with 51 2s are and write here 102. Now you have 24. Always remember, when you subtract the number, check the remainder. It should be always less than the divisor. If by chance you are getting greater than the divisor or exactly the divisor, you have done some mistake. So you need to recheck the things. Fine. So now this is 24 and one digit you need to bring down. Now it is 248. For 248, you need to think that how many times 51 goes into that. But actually, as I said, you have to think of 5 table only. So 5 fours are 20 and 5 fives are 25 and you have added 0 to that. So 5 fives are 25 is greater than this number. So you have to do 51 fours are. So here I have 204. Fine. So I will write it as 51 fours are 204. And now I am left out with 44. I will check whether it is less than 51 or not. Yes. Now I will bring 6 down. Now the number is 446. And I have to think how many times 51 will go into this number. I will just speak the table of 5. 5 8s are 40 and 5 9s are 45. So here 450 is greater than this number. So I will go for 5 8s are 40. So actually 551 into 8. So here I have 408. So I will write it as 408, and now I have this to be 38. I will check whether it is less than the divisor or not. Yes, it is so. So I got the quotient as 248 and remainder is 38. Now I need to verify this answer also. Always, whenever you get time, please ensure your answers. So here what I have is, fine, and I will add 38 remainder to that. So here I have 12,686. Now let's see the another question. Let us see this question now. 49,872 divided by 68. So now how to start with? The divisor has two digits. So first of all, you need to check first two digits of the dividend. So here it is 49, which is smaller than the divisor. So first step is that you need to write 00. Fine. And now add one more digit to that. So here you have to check whether how many times 68 goes in 498. So here, as I said, you have to make rough column, and now we will round off this number, fine, as I said, to get the answer fast. Now 68, that is, again, you know that it is nearer to 70, fine. So higher place, you can think that instead of 6, you can think of 7. Now you have to go on speaking the table of 7 and go on adding 0 to that. That is 7 5s are 35, so you will have 350. 7 6 are 42, this is 5s are 7 6 are 42, so 420. 7 7s are 49, so here this is 490. So either you can check this or this. Let us see then. So here I try with 68 into 6. So 6 8s are 48, 6 6 are 36 and 4. So it's 40. Now let's try with the next number, 68 7s are. So 8 7s are 56, 6 7s are 42 plus 5, 47. Fine. So here we have 7s are 476. Now when you subtract, what happens here? This is 2. This is 2. As soon as you subtract, you need to check this, is this smaller than this? If not, you have to check and go for still one more multiplication. Now bring one digit down, that is here it becomes 227, and now once again you have to go on estimating what the quotient you need to write. So here 7 3s are 21. So here it will be 210. 7 4s are, it will be 28, which is greater than that. So I need to check 68 into 3. So 8 3s are 24. 6 3s are 18 and 2 20. So here you have 68 3s are 204. And now this will be 3 and 2. This is smaller than this, so I can still move ahead. So now I have 232. This is 204. So again, I can go ahead with this only. 3s are 204. And now 12 minus 4 is 8. And this is 2, which is smaller than this. So yes, the answer is correct. I need to check it out. So what I need to do is 733 into 68, I have to do it. Let's do it. And here you can see when 733 is multiplied by 68, you get the answer as 49,844. And this remainder is added to that. So here you get 49,872, which was your quotient. With the next question, here you have to make the rough column first of all. And now the question is 19,687 divided by 35. So first of all, I will round off this number to the nearest 10. So here 5 is greater than or equal to, you have to check whether the condition is satisfied or not. So this was the underlined digit. So the condition is satisfied. So 3 becomes 4. So instead of thinking for 30, I will start thinking for 40 and move ahead, adding 0 to that. Now here the first two digits are 19, which is smaller than the divisor. So first two digits will be 0. I will go for the third digit also. So here the number becomes 196. And now I have to speak the table of 4. 4 5s are 20 and 10 4 added to that. So it becomes 200, which is greater than this number. So I can go with 35 4s are. So here I have 5 4s are 20, 4 3s are 12 and 2 14. And one more than that, 35 5s are when I do it. 5 5s are 25. 5 3s are 15 and 2 70. So this is 175. So here I have 5s are 175. And now the remainder is 1 2. This is smaller than this number. So 8 I will bring it down. Now here this number is 280. I have to go on speaking the table of 4. 4 5s are 20. And 4 6 are 24, which is greater than this number. So I can move with 35 into 6 are. So 6 5s are 30, 6 3s are 18 and 3 21. So here I have 6 are 210. So this is 8. Now I need to verify that if 8 is smaller than this or not. Yes, it is so. Now I will bring 7 also down. So here 35, 2s are 70. And now I am left out with 70. Okay. So here my quotient is 562. I now see here when 562 into 35 we have done. We have this answer, and when remainder is added to that, we have this dividend. Fine. So our answer is verified.